Hey, this is Sarah Kelly, and you're watching The Zone. Tiffany, and you are watching The Zone. Today we have a special twist on things. Joining us from time to time with Jenny will be goatee artist Sarah Kelly to speak with us ladies about the things she's learned about relationships. Plus, we have some free stuff to give away and your favorite music videos. To start us off, here's Jeremy Camp with Let It Fade on The Zone.
Have you been walking on a surface that's uncertain? Have you helped yourself to everything that's empty? Yeah. You can't live this way too long. There's more than this, more than this. Have you been standing on your own feet too long? Have you been looking for a place where you belong? You can rest, you will find rest. You can rest, you will find rest. Let this old life crumble, let it fade. Let this new life offer. Been holding on to what this world has offered. Have you been giving in to all these masquerades? It will be gone, forever gone. It will be gone, it will be gone. Let this old life crumble. Let this new life offer be your saving grace. Let this old life crumble, let it fade, let it fade, let it fade. Are you too long. Have you been looking for a place where you belong?
Hey, today I'm hanging out with goatee recording artist Sarah Kelly. And before, Sarah and I were just, you know, kind of talking about life and music and just kind of how when she was younger she got into maybe some bad relationships. For you, it started at a young age, didn't it?
No, it did. It started about age 13. I went to a new school, Christian school. You know how it goes, you know, junior high happens. But, you know, I think there's a choice at some point whether to indulge in your self-hatred, like at that age, or to move on from it. And
right.
I think I just chose to believe what everyone was saying about, and you start to believe these things about yourself.
Yeah.
And I remember looking in a mirror and just hating myself, not even just the outside, but like the inside. Like I hated myself so passionately. And then in eighth grade, I figured out a trick. If you date an older guy, like an 11th grader, okay, all of the girls all of a sudden like you because they want to date his friends.
Friends.
Okay, yeah. Can I just tell you, girls, if an 11th grader likes you and you're an 8th grader, it's not for your brains. I started my first physically abusive relationship at that age.
Gosh.
But bruises heal.
Yeah.
But I would do anything to get those girls off my back. It's a trade. It was the lesser of two evils. So I started down a real bad path and was one relationship after another. I mean, it really was. One out of four girls will be physically abused in their homes.
Wow.
Okay? And that's one
that's
out of
crazy.
Four of us. And I do think it is an issue that does need to be discussed.
We'll hear more from Sarah about her story soon, and we'll have more music videos coming up right after this.
She was helping them. She has something even harder to be mentioning. Like every single day I struggle just with fitting in. Plus the boys won't give me no attention and I get teased and made fun of all my friends and then...
Welcome back to The Zone. Today we have special guest Sarah Kelly in the house, and we're discussing relationships and abuse.
Sarah Kelly.
I got married at age 20, and I mean, these are all God-loving church people, you know, but they have an anger problem.
Wow.
You know, and we all have our issues. I mean,
it's
just time to unmask them, you know, and unfortunately, sometimes church isn't the easiest place to tell your problems.
Right.
Especially those kind.
Nobody said, hey, Sarah, I really feel like there's something going on.
No, my sister, you have to understand that abuse, self-hatred is an addiction. It's a dangerous addiction. It has drugs of choice, an eating disorder, cutting, which I felt, I totally was a cutter from the time I was 14 to 16. Well, eventually you get tired of hurting yourself, so you look for someone else to do it. So what girls that dabble in this stuff don't recognize is really, I would truly beg them to look at the road that your life is on right now. You are headed towards abusive relationships being okay in your life.
But what made you turn and say, you know what, it's not worth committing
eventually,
suicide?
Eventually. Anybody in this circumstance is going to come to the end of themselves. My sister, she said, Sarah, I'm realizing that, you know, you're mentioning that he's throwing a lot of things, and you're mentioning that, you know, I saw a chair that was demolished in your backyard the other day. What was that about? You know, like abuse victims, they get to this point where a guy can hurt you, and you're apologizing in a half hour.
I'm sorry.
You are apologizing for him hurting you.
Yeah.
Within a half hour. So my sister was like, she said, you know, you can't make him throw something. Do you understand that? And then she gave me these abuse papers with a cycle of abuse. And I didn't talk to her for like 2 months. People wonder why women stay until you're one of them. And you can't have close friends because then they
would know.
They would know. So abuse only exists in isolation. I mean, it really took everything, every ounce of anything I had left. Hold my breath and get through it, leave, and let me tell you, the fog has cleared and I have never been happier.
That's awesome.
More music and more from Jenny and Sarah Kelly is coming up, including your chance to win a free CD. You are watching The Zone. Welcome back to The Zone. I'm your host, Tiffany. Today, we're joined by recording artist Sarah Kelly, and she wants to share her hopes with you.
Every album is like a mirror to my heart. That's one thing I always promise people. I'm an artist, and I don't try to sell albums with my music. I really don't. Mm-hmm. What I try to do is make a mirror to my heart, the most honest portrayal of where I'm at with God. It's the most personal thing I have. Mm-hmm. I promised God a long time ago that I will sing in any room for you.
Oh, that's cool.
I'm not caught up if it's a church or if it's not. Mm-hmm. I'll sing anywhere about your goodness. I'm telling you, it's 3 years out now. The fog has lifted. Joel 2 says that he will restore unto you the years the locusts have eaten. And that is truly where I'm at right now. Yeah. Like, I get that. Like, all those years of cutting, all those years of falling to the sin of self-hate, mm-hmm. all those years of being hurt by people uh-huh. that I should have been able to trust, right. all those years are being restored to me. And let me tell you, I'm in some good years right now.
That's awesome.
I am in some good years. I'm here to tell you today that there is restoration. There is restoration for what you're going through right now. If you will just plow through it and trust God and worship, there is a payday. There is a payday for that. Mm-hmm. I've made the decision to not only love God mm-hmm. in my worship, but to accept His love for me. I don't think we as Christians are called to understand. I think we're called to worship through our circumstances and truly give glory to God and say, okay, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'll give this to you and I'm going to trust you. I'm going to continually choose to trust you, because right now you almost look cruel, but I'm going to choose to trust you anyways, because I know that life is not as it seems right now. The whole idea of grace, mm-hmm. I get what that means now.
Yeah.
I get what grace is.
Like, it's not just a song.
You can taste life a little bit better, and you can see the colors a little bit more brighter. And when you understand what grace is, like His mercy is on you every morning, I'm dependent on those now.
Till the morning light.
So at about midnight, awaiting this dawn, yes, I'll find contentment, Lord. I'm just singing out your song.
I'm Tiffany, and you now find yourself watching The Zone. Today we featured a video from rockers Remedy Drive, and now you have a chance to win a free copy of their newest CD. To enter to win, all you have to do is go to surfthezone.com, click on contest, and in the comments box type the word Remedy, and you could win. Now back to Sarah Kelly for one final thought.
Hey, this is Sarah, and I know we covered some really heavy topics today, but I just wanted to wrap up and say, you know, a couple good ways to not find yourself in an abusive relationship ever, a couple keys. Girls, try not to date guys that are more than a year older than you until you're out of high school. I know you're gonna hate me for that, but just think of me as Auntie Sarah. And then second of all, look in the mirror every day and really try to say out loud, oh my gosh, I'm so beautiful. I mean, I know it's awkward, but try. And some self-esteem might actually grow inside of you. Another thing is, guys out there, and girls, if you feel like throwing something, don't throw it, because that's where abuse begins. If the cell phone is leaving your hand and hitting the wall, you're on a bad path. Get it under control while you can. And I wish you the best. Be good to yourselves, because until we're good to ourselves, we can't expect anyone else to be good to us. All right? I love you. Have a good life.
At about midnight, I'll call. Yes, at about midnight, I will call out your name. 'Cause I need you beside me through these seasons of change, yes. So at about midnight, awaiting this dawn, yes, I'll find contentment just singing out your songs. And here in this valley, though the shadows lead my way, yes, I know that you're with me, Lord, where the past meets today. Where the past meets today. And seasons, they come and they go, yes. Your seasons, they come and they go with the night. But because you are with me, Lord, things will turn. So at about midnight, awaiting this dawn, yes, I'll find contentment, Lord. I'm just singing out your songs.